I'll never forget the day Lincoln got sick. He was my sister's youngest, at the time a beautiful, healthy 3-year-old. My sister Erica and I are extremely close. Between us, we have 9 kids. We live a block apart from each other and we're constantly at each other's houses. The day Lincoln got sick, our world turned upside down. What started as a routine doctor's appointment for paleness and bruising turned into every parent's worst nightmare. Lincoln had a severe case of aplastic anemia. A virus had shut down his bone marrow. He wasn't producing red cells, white cells, or platelets. A simple cold or cut could kill him. If you're a parent, you know what it is to feel powerless sometimes when it comes to your kids. Waiting for a donor is a special kind of helplessness. Watching my amazing sister and her husband go through that was so difficult. Any of us would have given anything we had to save Lincoln, but none of us could. So we did what any family would do if they're waiting for a miracle. We had hospital room dance parties, Uncle Andrew found a way to get Lincoln to take his terrible tasting medication, and Henry shaved his head in solidarity. And we prayed that out there, somewhere, there was a match for Lincoln. After weeks of blood transfusions, waiting, and praying, we got the call we'd been waiting for. Lincoln had a match. One match in the world. Not only a compatible donor, but a perfect 10 out of 10 match. On September 21st, 2016, Lincoln received his life-saving transplant. Because of this generous stranger, we have our boy back, our beautiful, healthy 5-year-old. I often wonder what would have happened if this anonymous donor hadn't taken the time to register. We think about this angel every day. So how do you thank a stranger for saving your loved one's life? This is how I do it, by telling Lincoln's story, so maybe you'll consider being a donor. If you're between the ages of 17 and 35, you can register. Go to onematch.ca to find out how you can be a miracle to another family, just like ours.